friends, welcome back. Let's continue with the architectural models of the distributed system. So in the previous video, I explained about the client-server distributed systems. Now let's see the peer-to-peer model. So unlike the client-server, the peer-to-peer models does not distinguish between client and server. So whereas in this client-server, the different client systems are there, they are connecting one server. So here these client and server can act as a, sometimes it acts as a servers and sometimes it acts as a client based on the requirement. And here there is a concept of one should be slave and another should be the master. But here in the peer to peer, each node can either be client or server depending on whether the node is requesting or providing the server. Means here each system, whatever the system you are taking, each system is acting as client as well as the server. It can act as a client as well as the server. So this is a peer to peer. So here each node means each system, you call it as a peer. So these peer systems are all connected to the network. So all are connected in the network. And now these systems, how they are going to be communicated? Based on their requirement. Okay. So this system can request and this system as well as it can reply, because this each system can act as server as well as a client. That is a peer-to-peer model. Instead, each node can either be a client or a server depending on whether the node is requesting or providing the service. Suppose it is requesting means it can be a client. Suppose it is responding means it may be act as a server. So this is an architecture of the peer-to-peer model. Let me show you here. So peer 1, peer 2 means different systems are there. Let me take n systems are present in the network. These system is having their applications, their own applications. That application is having those objects, different objects. Even those objects can be shareable. Those objects are shareable. Means the peer 1 system objects can share by peer 3, and the peer 3 can share the objects to peer n, and here the peer 3 can share peer 4 or 2, means like anything. So whenever it is sharing, it becomes a server, the other becomes the client. Whenever it is this system is sharing, it becomes a server and this becomes a client. Okay, so each system can act as a client as well as server in the peer-to-peer model. So let's see the pattern of communication. So here this is, did you see this pattern of communication? This pattern of communication between the systems depends entirely on application requirements. So it's this pattern, this type of communication is completely entirely depends on application requirement. So here did you observe these two systems are not connected? Why it is not connected? Because this system don't want the objects of this system and this system don't want the object of this system. So that's why the pattern of communication between them depends entirely on application requirements. Each object is replicated in several computers to further distribute the load and to provide resilience in the events of disconnection of individual computers. So this is one of the important. So here these objects are shared to the peer 3. Suppose this peer 2 wants that object, it can share, take from peer 3. It don't want to build a connection to peer 1 because these objects are already distributed in peer 3. So that is it. Each object is replicated in several computers to further distribute it, the load and to provide resilience in the event of disconnection of individual computers. And it need to place and retrieve, okay? It need to place and retrieve individual computers is more complex than in the client-server architecture. So this is one of the disadvantages here. Because it needs to place and retrieve the individual computers, which is a more complex when compared to the client-server architecture. Okay, so this is about the peer-to-peer communication model. Thank you.